بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Someone asked for the chain of transmission to this work, Imam al-Baydawi's Tafsir, rahimahullah ta'ala wa nafa'ana bihi ameen. I narrated from two of my teachers. First one is the renewer of Sunni education, the hafiz of hadith, and the chair of the departments of Qur'an and Sunnah in the universities of Damascus and Aleppo, and author of more than 50 books, Dr. Nuruddin Idr bin Muhammad bin Hassan al-Hussein al-Azhar al-Hanafi, hafizahullah. And the second one is the alim of qira'at and muhaddith and faqih of Damascus also, Dr. Muhammad Samir ibn Mamduh ibn Sharif al-Nas, hafizahullah. The former narrates from his teacher, his maternal uncle and father-in-law, Sheikh Abu Najib Abdullah ibn Muhammad Najib ibn Muhammad Sirajuddin al-Hussein al-Halabi, and the latter from our teacher, the faqih, Sheikh Muhammad Adib ibn Ahmad ibn al-Hajj Dib Kallas. The former from his father, the hadith scholar and exegete, Sheikh Muhammad Najib Sirajuddin al-Husseini al-Halabi, and the latter from the Mufti of Sham, Sayyid Muhammad Abu Yusr Abidin. Both Sheikh Muhammad Najib Sirajuddin and Sheikh Muhammad Abu Yusr Abidin from the Muhaddith al-Akbar of Damascus, Sheikh Badruddin al-Hassani al-Maghribi, with his chain to Imam al-Baydawi, which inshallah can be detailed to those who ask for it. Now, last time I had mentioned that Shawkani had said that the majority of the scholars considered that the Ism al-Jalala, the name Allah, was derived, but this is not the case. This is what Ar-Razi said. As for Ash-Shawkani, he was of the contrary opinion, that the majority say it is not derived. So it was my mistake, I was mentioning it from memory, but then I reviewed my notes, and that's what they said. Now, Imam al-Razi has this beautiful book which has been printed in Arabic, but I don't have a hard copy of it. So I got a French translation, A Treatise on the Divine Names. Quite thick, about 700 pages almost, in which he says that he prefers the position that the name Allah is underived. And then he mentions his reasons, and he says it is also the position of Imam al-Shafi'i, Abu Hanifa, al-Husayn ibn al-Fadl al-Bajali, al-Qaffal al-Shashi, Sulaiman al-Khattabi, Abu Yazid al-Balkhi, Imam Ghazali, and some of the philologists such as al-Khalil, Sibawayh, and al-Mubarrid. Then he says that the great majority of Mu'tazilis and of linguists and philologists consider that it is derived. Then, a couple of pages later, he mentions that among Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, Al-Harith ibn Asad al-Muhasibi, rahimahullah, considered that it is derived. And the majority of the scholars also. So, of course, the claim of consensus and of majority is a subjective claim. It's not, it needs istiqra. And it appears that if Imam al-Razi mentions that the majority of the scholars hold the opposite of what he himself considers the correct position, then it should be reliable. because it goes against his grain. And so then he should be trusted in conveying something which does not support his own position. Allahu ta'ala a'lam. Be as it may, now we start with Imam al-Baydawi's texts on al-Rahman al-Rahim. بالإسناد المتصل إلى الإمام الناصر الدين أبي الخير عبد الله ابن عمر ابن محمد ابن علي البيضاوي رحمه الله تعالى ونفعنا به أمين قال والرحمن الرحيم اسمان بنيا للمبالغة من رحمة كالغضبان من غضبة والعليم من علمة. Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim are two intensive form nouns derived from Rahima. Yani intensive meaning fa'lan and fa'il, as opposed to what? As opposed to fa'il. That would be the basic subject active form, fa'il. So then you have fa'al, and mutafa'il, fa'lan, and fa'il, and so forth. So these are the intensive forms. So these are two intensive forms derived from what verb? Rahima, which means he showed compassion. Like ghadban, angry, from ghadiba, and alim, knowing, from alima. So intensively we should say very angry for ghadban and very knowing for alim. قال والرحمة في اللغة رقة القلب وانعطاف يقتضي التفضل والإحسان ومنه الرحم لانعطافها على ما فيها. Mercy, he says, lexically is tenderness of the heart and an inclination that dictates the showing of favor and good treatment. Whence, yani from what we get, rahim, womb, since the latter curves around its content. Curves is related to inclination in itaf, something that inclines towards something else. But in itaf, better than inclination, probably we should say enfolds, enfolding. Now, of course, first thing that comes to mind is how can this apply to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because tenderness of heart, inclination, and enfolding. So he says, وَأَسْمَاءُ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى إِنَّمَا تُؤْخَذُ بِاعْتِبَارِ الْغَايَاتِ الَّتِي هِيَ أَفْعَالٌ دُونَ الْمَبَادِئِ الَّتِي تَكُونُ انْفِعَالَاتٌ. But the names of Allah are taken only in consideration of outcomes, غايات, which are acts, يعني divine acts. So you have to explain the name not by its literal definition and examples, but rather by the act, the divine act that it can denote. And then he says, the names of Allah are taken only in consideration of outcomes, which are acts, and not of inceptions, which are affects. So because Allah is never affected by anything. غير منفعل هو الفعال لما يريد. So he can never be called subject to anger, let's say, or subject to happiness, or subject to contentment, satisfaction. Although rida and ghadab are among his attributes, right? Similarly, mercy. But he cannot be called subject to taking pity or feeling pity. See, because these are infi'alat, being subject to, being the passive subject of something, being the patient of something. No, this is not, cannot be applied to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore he says, therefore the divine names are taken only on, in consideration of outcomes, not in consideration of inceptions, al-mabadi, yani the principles of the principle of mercy and the way that mercy begins and manifests itself in the heart and in the flesh and the emotions and so forth, that cannot be applied to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now the a complete treatment of this kind, this principle, which is an Ash'ari principle, can be found in the book of Ibn Abd al-Salam al-Izz, al-Imam al-Kabir al-Usuli, al-Ishara ila al-Ijaz fi ba'di anwa' al-Majaz. Because all of the, these attributes such as mahabba, friendship, wood, love, rida, good pleasure, gratitude, shukr, laughter, dahik, happiness, farah, patience, sabr, jealousy, ghira, ruse, khida, astonishment, and also makr, scheming, astonishment, ajab, and distance, as when we say dhalika and dhalikum, leisure, faragh, hesitancy, taraddud, in the hadith. Allah does not hesitate as much as when he wants to seize, he decides to seize the soul of his servant back to him. What is this hesitation? Is it never the same as the hesitation of creatures? Similarly, the establishment over the throne, istiwa, the bearing of the shin, kashf al-saq, wrath, ghadab, resentment, sukht or sakhat, grief, asaf, hatred and spite, bold, maqt, qila, enmity, adawa, malediction, la'an. All of these, you have to apply the explanation of them and their translation and their understanding to the outcomes that they denote and connote. So, the rida of Allah, according to this method of Imam Izz ibn Abd al-Salam and the school of the Ash'aris, the rida of Allah is whatever act Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does towards the one who did something good to incur his good pleasure. So it is the act and the outcome and the thing that is lavished on that servant, that is what how the rida of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is explained. Not as the rida of creatures, which is a kind of inward feeling and emotion of contentment and acceptance and attraction towards the object of the rida. You see the difference? Okay. Similarly, sukht would be punishment, and love would be to give them hifz and tawfiq and isma, to bring them near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is the love of Allah. It is not like love of creatures, because laysa kamithlihi shay'un wa huwa as-sami'u al-basir. ثم قال والرحمن أبلغ من الرحيم.
قال إنما تؤخذ باعتبار الغير هذه موقف الأشاعرة.
نعم.
غير المعتزلة بالصلاة.
المعتزلة يعني موقفهم من الصفات موقف تعطيلي ويعني يعني يثبتون اللفظ ولكن يعني يعطلون المعاني فلا يؤولون أصلا أو إذا يؤولون بدون إثبات حقيقة المعنى فيحولون يصرفون المعنى الحقيقي إلى ما يطابق مقياس تنزيههم لله سبحانه وتعالى من التشبيه. طيب أما المجسمة يثبتون الصفة ويقولون بلا كيف مع التشبيه، يعني تشبيه بلا تشبيه، لأنه يوهمون التجسيم والتجسيد، يقولون يد حقيقية واستواء حقيقي فوق وعلى وبالذات وكذا، فهذا يوهم الجسم
هم لا يقولون إذن
والتحيز. أما الأشاعرة فبين وبين الطريق الوسط. والرحمن أبلغ من الرحيم لأن زيادة البناء تدل على زيادة المعنى، هذه قاعدة لغوية، أن زيادة البناء تدل على زيادة المعنى، ولكن غير ليست من الكليات، يعني غير مضطردة، يعني this is usually the case not always، كما في قطع وقطع وكبار وكبار، وذلك إنما يؤخذ تارة باعتبار الكمية وأخرى باعتبار الكيفية. فعلى الأول قيل يا رحمن الدنيا، لأنه يعم المؤمن والكافر، ورحيم الآخرة لأنه يخص المؤمن، يعني كمية الكافر والمؤمن وكمية المؤمنين. وعلى الثاني قيل يا رحمن الدنيا والآخرة ورحيم الدنيا، لأن النعم الأخروية كلها جسام يعني عظيمة، وأما النعم الدنيوية فجليلة وحقيرة يعني صغيرة. فهذه بالنسبة للكيفية نعم الدنيا والآخرة باعتبار الكيفية، تمام. الترجمة: الرحمن is more intensive than الرحيم since addition in morphology يعني the form of the word spells addition in meaning. If you have the same cognates but one of them has an additional letter and they are from the same root, it means that this addition is not gratuitous, it doesn't just, it's not indifferent, it makes a difference. The difference is what? The difference is addition in meaning. Addition in letter means addition in meaning in Arabic. It might not be the case in other languages, but in Arabic that's how it works, most of the cases. And in some cases, Imam Suyuti said, the reverse is true. And he gave the example of Hadir and Hadir. Hadir, to be cautious. Hadir is to be even more cautious. Even though there is the additional letter is in the first case, Hadir. I'm sure if you can find more examples like that. Perhaps Fatin and Fatin. Fatin is for one thing that you realize about one thing, but Fatin is your nature is that you are clever or intelligent or perceptive of things. So al-mu'minu kayyisun fatinun. ليس كيس قطن. This is an example that Dr. Wahab Zuhairi gave in class of the tasheef of miswriting kayis and fatin as kis and qutun. So it changes the meaning from the believer is kayis fatin, yani clever and intelligent, to he is a kis qutun, he is a bag of cotton, which is an ugly mistake in pronunciation and hence meaning. Type. We go back to the rule that usually addition in morphology spells addition in meaning. As in, Baydawi says, as in qata'a, he cut, and qatta'a, he cut to pieces. Or kubar, big, and kubbar, huge, which must be understood in regard to quantity at times and modality at others. In the first case, it was said, O Rahman of this world, for the latter includes the believer and the unbeliever, and Rahim of the next, for it is exclusive to the believer. Meaning the Rahmah of Rahim is exclusive to the believer in the next world. So, in this sense, that's why I chose for Ar-Rahman the all-beneficent, because it follows this kind of understanding, which has been given by many, many scholars of tafsir, that Ar-Rahman is for everyone in this world only. So it all beneficent. And then Ar-Rahim is only for the believers in Akhirah. So we want to reflect that in the translation, so we'll say most merciful. Most merciful, meaning to the believers. You see? So all beneficent, most merciful. But in reality, as Baydawi said, they both mean Rahmah in an intensive form. Yani more all merciful and most merciful, both of them. But in order to reflect this this difference that is proposed in meaning. In the second case, so this is quantitatively of the believers and the unbelievers. In the second case, the qualitative case, it was said, O Rahman of this world and the next, and Rahim of this world only. Because next worldly favors are all momentous, they're all huge, great, while this worldly favors are both weighty and trifling. So in reality, of course, in spiritual terms, there is no such thing as a trifling favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّ الْقَلِيلَ مِنْكَ كَثِيرٌ. Even little from you is a lot. If even a lover can say that to his beloved from creatures, so how much more does it, you know, must it be said of the, you know, the Creator? But he means by that, that, I mean, of course, life is an even greater favor than health. Health is an even greater favor than wealth. And so on and so forth. So we must, you know the hierarchy of favors in order to be more thankful for the priorities and the greatest ones. And therefore, in relation to others, some are, can be considered less momentous. That's what he means by haqira, trifling, yani small, small favors. يمنعون الماعون, ماعون, small favors. وإنما قدم it was pointedly put first. Yani Ar-Rahman, yeah, why he brings that up? Because he just said that Ar-Rahman has one more letter, and it has therefore one, it has more meaning, it has more intensity. So why was it put first? It was pointedly put first. Well, وإنما قدم والقياس يقتضي الترقي من الأدنى إلى الأعلى. Although the rule dictates a progression from lower to higher. أولا لتقدم رحمة الدنيا. ثانيا ولأنه صار كالعلم. I am numbering here. It's not in his text. ولأنه صار كالعلم من حيث إنه لا يوصف به غيره. لأن معناه المنعم الحقيقي البالغ في الرحمة غايتها وذلك لا يصدق على غيره لأن من عداه فهو مستعيض بلطفه وإنعامه يريد به جزيل ثواب أو جميل ثناء أو يزيح رقة الجنسية أو حب المال عن القلب ثم إنه كالواسطة في ذلك لأن ذات النعم ووجودها والقدرة على إيصالها والداعية الباعثة عليه والتمكن من الانتفاع بها والقوى التي بها يحصل الانتفاع إلى غير ذلك من خلقه لا يقدر عليها أحد غيره. Subhanallah. So it was pointedly put first, Ar-Rahman, first, although the rule dictates a progression from lower to higher, because the mercy of this world takes place first. Two, because it has become like a proper name, since none other than Allah is described by it. This is the qaida shar'iyya that I mentioned before, that this cannot be, this is like Allah among the names, can only be applied to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whereas all the other attributes, except for muhyi and mumit, for example, yani most of the rest of the attributes, except those that, that are near synonymous to divinity, can only can be shared with creatures. And so this one, Ar-Rahman, has become like a proper name for it. For its meaning is the true grantor of bounty who reaches the utmost in mercy. The true grantor of bounty who reaches the utmost in mercy. Such is untrue of any other than him, since all others aim to obtain repayment in exchange for giving kindness and favor. See, so any other merciful one, meaning among the creatures, has an ulterior motive or aims to, expects repayment of some sort. One either wants lavish compensation or fine praise or to allay the sensitivity of human sympathy. And you have a pang in your heart when you see someone who is poor because you identify with them. So you diminish that pang and you treat it by giving some of your property, makes you feel good. This is a clinical description of pity, the workings of pity in the heart. So in reality, you are the one who's gaining from the beginning to end, subhanallah. And you are in fact giving to yourself. So, or to allay the sensitivity of human sympathy. Sympathy in the strong clinical sense here. Yani sympathy meaning that you are feeling the same pain. You are empathizing, more than empathizing, you are like in complete synchronicity of pain or suffering. Now, this riqqat al-jinsiyas, this is the wording in what we read is يُزِيحُ رِقَّةَ الْجِنْسِيَّةِ, and we translate it as the sensitivity of human sympathy. جنسية يعني أنت مجانس لهذا البشري. تمام؟ نفس الجنس البشري. تمام؟ هذه رقة الجنسية، رقة بمعنى الرقاقة. رقة بمعنى الشيء الرقيق، ليس بمعنى الانسليفمنت. بمعنى
تندر.
تندر، يا تندرنس. So the tenderness of human sympathy, sensitivity. And there are other editions that have here, there is a lot of discrepancy in the manuscript, sorry. There is anafat al-khissa or ribqat al-khissa instead of riqqat al-jinsiyya. So what is anafat al-khissa? Khissa means something mean and lowly, yani of low character. So you want to remove the shame of low character. You give, because giving generosity is the mark of nobility. So again, it's a way to raise yourself, raising your image by doing the act of something that is attributed to someone of high character. And ribqat instead of riqqa. Ribqat is like the noose, the noose that one ties around the neck of an animal or even a person. So that ribqat al-khissa, the noose of meanness, as if one is a slave to their low character. So you want to remove that by what? By giving sadaqah. And Shaykh al-Islam explains here, Zakaria al-Ansari, in his commentary on Baydawi, that is, a human being is inherently a miser, stingy, and loves money. وَأُوْتِيَتْ النُّفُوسُ شُحْهَا شُحْهَا طيب. And loves money. So when he does someone a favor, he only wants to curb the slavish grip of his human character by doing something that contradicts his basic nature, which is inherently miserly, as is the common lot of those of his genus, his jins, his species, in order to be praised for doing so. MashaAllah. So once one wants to remove that, or love of money from the heart, so when you are conscious of that, so in, of course, in tariqah, you have to force yourself, you have to work on it, and you keep checking your heart. Are you still attached? You have to give more. You're still attached, you have to give more. Like Imam Sahl al-Tustari, he said that al-ithm, ظاهر الإثم وباطنه. He says, what is Dahir al-Ithm? Is it's doing sins. That's Dahir al-Ithm. Batinuhu, what's Batin al-Ithm? The hidden sin? No, he says, Batin al-Ithm is to still love doing it, even after you give up doing it. Subhanallah. Now, so removing love of money from the heart. Moreover, he says, وَالدَّاعِيَةَ sorry, ثُمَّ إِنَّهُ كَالْوَاسِطَةِ فِي ذَلِكَ. Moreover, one is like a mere intermediary in that, since the favors themselves, their existence, the power to deliver them, the motivation and stimulus to obtain them, the ability to benefit from them, the powers by which such benefit takes place, and so forth, all of this is his creation, and none but he has power over it. Subhanallah. So we are just like custodians of our wealth and health. And all of this, you know, our enjoyment of our own strength or of our own possessions, of our own wealth and health, all of this, it's only through, because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is all his in reality, and we are metaphorically in charge. So we are like the intermediaries here. And this is, like I mentioned the story before, you may have heard it, of the the two awliya giving, one was giving the other a sadaqah, and he was saying, khudh laysa lak, meaning take, it's not for you, meaning goes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the others were saying, hat laysa mink, say, give it, it's not from you either, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's from Allah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, this is tawheed, and he mentions this spiritual understanding at the same time as he is, of course, mentioning basic definitions. So it is quite dense, and it can be at times also the grammar jargonesque, but don't give up. Whatever we gain from it, I mean, even for me, I get lost, as you see, I misquote and I lose the thread of what I'm saying. I have to check again. And if we get just 10% of the text, it is still a lot. 20%, whatever each one can take, and go back to it and take some more, and get some more. أو يقول لأن الرحمن لما دل على جلائل النعم وأصولها. He goes back now to explaining why Rahman comes first before Rahim. Just because he brought up the fact that Rahman is more intensive than Rahim, yet it comes first, so he gives the reasons why. And this is in order to explain for us more and more of the style of the Qur'an and the greatness of this style and the power of this passage of the Fatiha, al-Rahman, al-Rahim. أو لأن الرحمن لما دل على جلائل النعم وأصولها ذكر الرحيم ليتناول ما خرج منها فيكون كالتتمة والرديف له. Or after Ar-Rahman pointed to the sublime and fundamental favors, he mentioned Ar-Rahim to address everything outside the first purview, like a complement, complementing it, and in tandem with it, together with it. Or Ar-Radif is what comes just behind, like the rider in tandem behind the first rider. Like Sayyidina Ali behind the Prophet ﷺ, or Sayyidina al-Fadl ibn Abbas behind the Prophet ﷺ, or Abdullah ibn Abbas behind the Prophet, or Mu'adh ibn Jabal, Ya Mu'adh, I love you, that hadith. And he was riding right behind the Prophet ﷺ. أو للمحافظة على رؤوس الآي. Another reason would be to harmonize verse endings. Yes. So that it will sound closer to عالمين. رحمن الرحيم. العالمين. مالك يوم الدين. Verse endings. So this kind of rhythm, of course, is part of the beauty of the Quran and therefore part of its language and the ajaz. Part of its awesome, staggering miracle of style. النعم التي هي أكثر وصولا أو أكثر أنفع للاتصال، والله تعالى أعلم. نعم، الحقيقة أنا نظرت في هذا، نعم، ووجدت أن all the manuscripts and editions have وأصولها إلا هذه الطبعة. This is the Damascus and Beirut edition in three volumes. And your edition is the Sheikh Mahmoud al-Arnaout. Sheikh Mahmoud al-Arnaout. So they must have followed the same Microsoft Word file, I think. Because this one does not mention what manuscripts they used, if any. So they made it three volumes with footnotes and two colors, but This is not proper work. Not acceptable. And probably this one in the introduction, I think if we check, we'll find that not one word about the manuscripts used for that edition. So that's unfortunate. And then we perpetuate such mistakes and bigger ones as well. At least this one, you can find the makhraj for it. That is beautiful. Because it has the same kind of importance. That's what he wants to say. After the important ones, then the next types of favors. ثم قال والأظهر أنه غير مصروف وإن حضر اختصاصه بالله تعالى أن يكون له مؤنث على فعلى أو فعلانه إلحاقا له بما هو الغالب في بابه. Now we're still talking about Rahman here. And he says the predominant view is that it is indeclinable, does not have dual or plural or feminine. So he says the predominant view, it is indeclinable regardless of the fact that it is that it's being used exclusively for Allah precludes its having a feminine with the forms fa'la or fa'lana. If we sort it with the most frequent occurrences for its word type, what is its word type? Fa'lan. Fa'lan. So the most frequent occurrences and examples of fa'lan in the Arabic language will not will have feminine fa'la or fa'lana. نعم فهمانا. أنت فهمان. أنت فهمانا. You understand.
وإذا كان رحمن
male, you understand.
وإذا كان رحمن رحمانا. هذا قصده.
لا, he says despite that الرحمن is never found in in the feminine. طيب. That's the predominant view, meaning there is a minority view to the contrary. طيب. And so فعلا would be رحمة. رحمة. Yeah, like عظمى. عزة.
حسنى.
عزة, the feminine name عزة, the goddess, meaning the feminine of Al-A'az. So A'az becomes عزة in the feminine. Allah Ta'ala A'lam. نعم الحسنى for أحسن.
بشرى.
بشرى. بشرى is a noun, but it is originally أبشر, yeah. بشرى. وإنما خص التسمية بهذه الأسماء ليعلم العارف أن المستحق لأن يستعان به في مجامع الأمور هو المعبود الحقيقي الذي هو مول النعم كلها عاجلها وآجلها جليلها وحقيرها. So he chose to be named by these names, Rahman and Rahim, so that the knower in the technical sense here of the
Sufi.
Yes, the Sufi, the Imam Al-Ghazali discusses in the first book of Ihya Ulumuddin, Kitab al-Ilm, when he says Al-Alim Billah Huwa Al-Alim, Al-Ilm Billah Huwa Al-Ilm, Laysa Al-Ilm Bi Ahkam Allah. يقول يعني بمعنى أنه أيها الفقيه لا تغضب من كلامي لكن العلم بأحكام الله هو علم دنيوي. So Imam Ghazali says something very deep here in the first book of Ihya ul-Madin. He says true knowledge is knowledge of Allah. It's knowledge that has Allah as its object, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not knowledge that has the laws of Allah and the rulings of Allah as its object, because the second type of knowledge is a dunya knowledge, is a worldly knowledge. It ends. Its needs is limited. Whereas the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is the real knowledge. So therefore, the one that specializes in that, that is the real alim, the real knower. That's what we mean by al-arif. So of course, those who have disease in their heart against awliya Allah and ahlul haqq in this ummah, they will say, oh, Sufism, and they will immediately withdraw like a turtle in its shell. Snail in its shell, they don't want to touch it. Although that's the whole goal is to reach safa and purity in worship and ikhlas. So he says, so when the knower would realize that the one truly deserving to be sought for help in all matters is he who is truly worshipped. Majami al-umur, meaning all important matters, but can also mean all matters in absolute terms. Which Qunawi says here, it's more obvious. Majami al-kalim is the majami al-kalim that the Prophet ﷺ was given, yani the most concise expressions with the most encompassing meanings. Most encompassing, but also it also means all speech, all knowledge, all speech that qualifies as good speech, even if he did not say it all on record, but in reality it all comes from the mishkat of his station sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, in all matters, the one who ought to be sought for help, truly deserving to be sought for help in all matters, is he who is truly worshipped, who is the grantor of all favors, both the immediate ones and the deferred ones, both the sublime and the petty. So, the immediate ones in this world, the deferred ones after this life, and the sublime ones, of course, are the everlasting ones, and the petty ones are those that we do not even mention them, except generically. Right? But still, there is, for example, in the stories related from Bani Israel, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addresses Musa alayhi salam, and he says, oh Musa, I want you to ask me for everything, even the yeast in your flour or in your dough, and even the laces in your shoes. Ask me for everything and thank me for everything. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything. Everything, there is nothing insignificant that among the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we deny none of them. Should be like the story of the jinn when they heard فَبِأَيِّ آلَاءِ رَبِّكُمَا تُكَذِّبَانِ. They would all say لَا لَيْسَ بِشَيْءٍ. لا نكذب بشيء. The mu'min of the jinns, each one they would repeat that, and they would all say, we don't deny anyone, anything, nothing we deny. Rabbi, forgive us. And he says, فيتوجه, يعني, to that end, that's why we put it in the mansub, in the accusative, فيتوجه بشراشره إلى جناب القدس ويتمسك بحبل التوفيق ويشغل سره بذكره والاستعداد به عن غيره يرحمك الله. Allah grant us that. Ameen. So he says, turning therefore with every last shred of his being, that's what بِشَرَاشِرِهِ means. Every last shred of his being, right? So sharashiri, that's the plural of sharshara. And Qunawi says it is used to mean the soul and the body, and it originally means the tips of the wings and the tail. So it was used to mean the whole, the tips of the wing, the wings, and the tail. So you mean everything in between also. And so he says body and soul, as we would say body and soul. So and with every last shred of his being. You know? And by the way, in this edition, this expression, which is often used by Qadi Baydawi, is every time he uses it, they garble it to bisharri asharrihi. Bisharri asharrihi, yani with the most evil of his evil. Which is, not only doesn't make sense, but if it makes any sense, it's the worst sense possible. Yani you turn with your worst foot forward, it's astaghfirullah. So they don't ask themselves, it means nothing, we should change it. They just let it pass like that. And also in your edition, the Mahmoud Arnaout edition. Mm-hmm. See, so they share the same mistakes and reduplicate them. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. And so turning, therefore, with every last shred of his being to the Divine Presence and firmly grasping the rope of success, and this is divinely given success, God-given success. Tawfiq is not just any success. Engrossing his inward being with his remembrance and taking him as his sufficiency without any other. And then he says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. And this is where we will start next time, inshallah. Any questions?
The description of Imam Baydawi about the Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim also mirrors what Imam Ghazali mentioned in his 99 hymns.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Imam Ghazali has a book on the 99 names, Al-Asna fi Asma'illah al-Husna. And yes, indeed, he is one of the sources, unless they both share a common source, but you do find sometimes Ghazalian references in Baydawi, because after all, they were both of them were from the Khurasan region, from the Central Asian region of Islam at the time. So it stands to reason that he may have borrowed from him, and from that book in particular, and other books that are related to Tafsir among al-Ghazali's patrimony. Any other question?
شيخ أين الزيادة في البناء في الرحمن؟
الرحمن الرحيم. الميم.
ميم. أو ألف.
ميم. الرحمن. عفوا النون. النون.
نون.
النون والألف. الألف والياء. يعني الياء والألف واحد.
يعني الرحمن أربعة أحرف. رحيم أربعة
أحرف. الرحمن طيب رحمن رحمن رحيم راء حاء ياء ميم رحمن راء حاء ميم ألف نون
ألف بين الميم والنون.
نعم. جزاكم الله خير. وإياكم. والله كم حرف؟
ألف لام لام
لام.
الله ألف لام لام لام.
ألف لام لام ألف ها
ألف لام لام
ألف ها. نعم نحن قلنا لا يجوز أن نقول الله فالألف موجودة لا تكتب ولكن هي موجودة. تمام. اللهم تعالى أعلم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين. الحمد لله رب العالمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.